time because the makeup test is harder than the regular test. If you're 10 minutes late, they won't let you take your test.
Wow. And don't bring your cell phone in there because if your cell phone goes off, the whole class is going to have to take the test over.
That makes the whole class fail.
Right.
Wow.
Like, literally, what we did at CSA, I don't know about everybody in CSA, I know my particular class, and I took my test in, everybody got a strip. And everybody at CSA, mostly everybody in my grade, has a cell phone. If you say you don't have a cell phone, some part of you is lying. Because everybody in my 10th grade class, or 11th grade class now, has a cell phone. So everybody was given a strip with their name on it, like already printed out. Put your name on your phone and put it right on the desk. And they called you up one by one to get your phone. Because if your phone went off and it was on the desk, they take your phone and you don't get it back till you get your test scores back. Or your parents come up there. And even your parents like have to go through this whole thing with the principal. So my point is, if you got locker and you got a combination, leave it in the locker because...
Now, so do you guys take a test on a Saturday or on a regular school day?
Regular school day.
And how is the day structured? Do you go into homeroom and or do you take the test?
It differs for each school.
Yeah, it all depends. Like at our school, we like the teacher, like the class we took, that's the class we went in, right? So we had science, we went to our science. That was our homeroom for the day. Then after that we just had class.
See, ours was different. At CSA, each group of 10th graders were given one class to report to every day. And it wasn't like discriminated because we had like, because we figured like me, I thought it was unfair for them to make the like, our,